discuss about that grammar section as well as we already completed that poem section. Now we'll move ahead with another chapter, chapter number 4, A Truly Beautiful Mind. That chapter is about that famous person Albert Einstein, and whenever that we hear that Albert Einstein, the name of that person, as that moment that first question or the first name comes in our mind that related to that science as well as that physics, and who has given the formula of E is equal to mc square, as well as he has given the information about that relativity, gravity of relativity, like that he has given the information. So we'll move ahead to get more information about this famous scientist. That Albert Einstein was born on 14 March 1879. He was born in German, and the city name is Ulm. That means in German the city name is Ulm. He was born on 14th March 1879 in German city named Ulm. And when he was, that means he born at that moment, that he looked like a freak. Freak, that means we can say that look like a normal. We can say like that the abnormal. Physically, he was look like an abnormal person because he is having a little bit large head comparing to his other parts of the body. So according to his mother, he was a freak person, that means an abnormal personality. At the age of, and the one more clue is there, that at the age of 2.5 years, since he was not able to speak a single word. After completing the 2.5 years, he had started to speak a little bit. Though, and one more thing, that he was speaking each and every word twice. के ढाई साल के होने के बाद भी वो सारे वर्ड्स दो बार रिपीट करता था, लाइक दैट. एंड दैट्स व्हाई दैट द कंपेयरिंग टू अदर चिल्ड्रन ही इज लिटिल बिट स्लो. एंड वन मोर थिंग इज दैट के जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ दैट थिंग एंड दैट आइंस्टाइन डिड नॉट नो व्हाट टू डू विद द अदर चिल्ड्रन, एंड दैट्स व्हाई द प्लेमेट्स कॉल्ड हिम बोरिंग ब्रदर्स. इवन दैट ही इज नॉट, that means like to play with that human beings. He was very interested in mechanical toys and all. And one very interesting example is there, that once he was just observed his little bit small, that means sister, and newborn sister, when he observed her, at that moment he said to her, he asked her to her mother, his mother, that mama, actually everything is okay, but where is her wheels? कि उसके wheel कहाँ है? Even he is not having idea कि that her, his sister is not a toy. It's a, he is a, she is a human being. Though he has asked her this kind of question. After few years, that means his parents were called by that principal, school principal, and they have informed to that his parents, Albert Einstein's parents, that whatever in which field he wants to go, just let him go. Because we guarantee that person, that means Albert Einstein, will not become a successful person in any field. So whatever he wants to choose, that let him choose. So just because of that reason, that in the initial days, that his mother had started to give a violin or a guitar, and his mother once wanted that her son become a professional violinist. He has also started that to play a violin, and throughout his whole life he was playing a very nice violin. When he was, that means in school time, he was not what we can say, he was a very clever student, but he is having one bad habit. It is not called bad habit, but each and every time he was excusing with the teachers, and that's why the teachers didn't like. And just because of that reason, in very early age, at the age of only 50 years, he left the school. And even he left that place also, Munich, where he was completed his schooling years. And at the age of 15 years, he has already left that place. And he just shifted that for higher grade or for higher study, he has shifted at Zurich. And for further study, he shifted in Zurich University in Switzerland. And that Zurich place is a more liberal than that Munich. And that's why he just shifted over there for higher grade study or for higher study. And here that changes comes in his life. That first at he over there, that means in Zurich University, he met one person who is a classmate of him only, and whose name is Mileva Merik is a classmate, as well as she is having a same thinking like that Albert Einstein. They both are having the very good connection or connectivity. And that here the Zurich University is one of the university where the women get a more liberty comparing to the other place. And that's why many female or that women come over here to for higher studies. Even now, slowly and gradually, they are coming closer to each other. First, they have started to talk regarding their studies and all. And suddenly one day, that Albert Einstein proposed her in a scientific way or in a scientific manner. He said that Mileva, he wrote a letter to that Mileva, and he said that how happy and proud I will be when we both have brought our work on relativity to a victorious conclusion. कि अगर क्या अगर ये बात अच्छी होगी कि ये हमारी जो हमारी कनेक्टिविटी है वो लाइफ लॉन्ग तक चले, अगर मिलेगा ऐसा हो जाएगा तो बहुत अच्छा है. So and in 1900 at the age of 21 he has completed his graduation, completed his study, and still he was unemployed. He is not having any kind of job. In 1902, after completing the study, after 2 years, he got the job in one office where he wanted to observe that people, those who are research something. And privately, in the other side, he also started his own research. And after getting the job after that three years in 1905, he found that the special theory of relativity. According to him, he said that if we'll set the time of two different clocks, and if we'll keep them in a different places, after some time, if we'll take that clock in one place, and if we'll check that both the clocks will give different times, little bit different times should be there, like that he has given one formula. It is called the theory of relativity. That means according to the atmosphere, according to the weather, that the time changes. Like that he has given that one theory of relativity. And for that he has also given one formula, that E is equal to mc square. E, that means energy, m, that means mass, and c, that means speed. Like that he has given that formula. Now, slowly and gradually he became more famous in what we can say, that physics and science. But in the other side, his marital life is not little bit good. Actually, when he informed to the relation between him and that Mileva, he informed to his mother at that moment, his mother was against this relationship. Why? Because according to his mother, that Mileva is already old, 3 years older than him. And according to her, she said that they both are having the same field, as well as they both are intelligent, and she has a type of wrong belief that for her कि उसकी वाइफ के लिए अल्बर्ट आइंस्टाइन एक बुक बन के रह जाएगा. दैट्स व्हाई सी इज अगेंस्ट टू दैट रिलेशनशिप ऑफ दैट मिलेवा एंड दैट आइंस्टाइन. दो दे आर गोइंग अगेंस्ट हिज मदर एंड इन 1903 दे गॉट मैरिड. After that, after some time or within few years, they got two children, two sons. They had two sons, but that marriage life is not going in a smooth way. After some years, that slowly and gradually that fighting and that quarrel started because that Mileva Merrick became the unhappy housewife, and that's why in 1919. That couple had finally divorced 1919. And the interesting thing is that in the same year that Einstein got married with his cousin named Elsa, like that. And then he in 1915 that he published a general theory of relativity, and slowly and gradually he became a more famous person. At that moment then in Germany that Nazis power came, and at that moment that Einstein had already shifted in US, United States. So 5 years later, discovery of nuclear fission in Berlin had American physicists, and many of them the fascism as well as that Einstein had, they were afraid of the Nazis. So that's why that Einstein wrote a letter to that American President Franklin D. Roosevelt that please don't try or just don't try to use that nuclear bomb in any place because it was very dangerous. Though they have, that means American or that American government has that used that atom bomb, nuclear bomb on two cities of Japan country, that Hiroshima and Nagasaki. In 1945, August 1945, that they have dropped the nuclear bomb on two cities of Japan country. After that, when he heard this kind of bad news, at that moment he really hated this kind of things and all the things. That's why he started his work to be as a politician. And he started campaign for peace and democracy in the world. Like that, he started a campaign in the whole world for peace and democracy. And in 1955, at the age of 76 years, that a huge famous person, a huge personality as well as the famous scientist died. And while that means he was celebrated as the visionary and the world citizen as a scientific genius, and he got the title that he was a world citizen. He is not having a citizenship of any one country. He got the what we can say title as a world citizen and the scientific genius as a world for the world. I hope you understood whatever I explained in this chapter or videos. If you are having any doubt, whenever we have online session, at that moment we'll solve your doubts. Thank you and have a nice day.